Anyone who's been with my channel for long enough knows that I'm a filthy slut for the synthwave or new retrowave aesthetic. It's also easily one of my favorite genres of music. So you can bet your ass when I saw the first trailer for Blood Machines, I lost my mind. It's not often filmmakers intentionally go for the heavily vibrant neon look. Blood Machines is basically what would happen if you took an episode of Cowboy Bebop, peppered in some Ghost in the Shell and End of Evangelion, especially the third impact scene, and then covered it in a thick layer of like neon icing. Now, if that doesn't sound awesome to you, and we just can't be friends anymore, man. Two salvagers, I guess? Or maybe they're supposed to be space hunters? I don't know. And their ship's AI system, Tracy, take down a ship that crash lands on some unexplored planet. When they land, a bunch of women show up and perform some kind of ritual that allows the downed ship's AI system to become a literal cosmic ghost in the machine, who our main characters then chase deep into the reaches of space. And yes, the plot is about as crazy as this entire movie is. I don't really think I need to say anything about the visuals. I mean, just look at this shit. It's amazing. Especially when you consider that this was just a Kickstarter project with a very small budget, yet it somehow manages to look better than some Hollywood movies. And that's just nuts. And unfortunately, some of the coolest shots in the entire movie are just loaded with female nudity, so I can't even show them on YouTube. But believe me when I say, it is absolutely breathtaking. And there isn't a whole lot of behind-the-scenes stuff for Blood Machines out there that I could find, but from what I could tell just by watching it, it seemed to be like a mixture of miniature work and visual effects that were done by six different visual effects studios. Either way, what director Seth Ickerman and his team managed to pull off here with so little money is just, it's impressive. It's really impressive. And if all that wasn't already awesome enough, the entire soundtrack is done by one of the best names in the synth game, Carpenter Brut. After watching the movie, I did some research and quickly realized that there's actually a music video for one of Carpenter's songs called Turbo Killer, which is pretty fucking cool in its own right, but it actually served as the inspiration for what would become Blood Machines. And if you don't know who Carpenter Brut is, their music was used mainly in Hotline Miami. The acting, however, it's not good. But when you consider the visual aesthetic of the movie and how much it just oozes 80s, and if you look at it as a product of that era, it's a hell of a good time. My only regret about Blood Machines is that it's too short. I would love a full-length film done with the same aesthetic. Flesh out some of the story bits, you know? I mean, there's just a world here that's just itching to be chewed at. But at its current length of 50 minutes, it lends itself quite well to being one of those movies that you can just watch repeatedly. If you want to have like a party or something, or if you just want to show somebody a good time, there you go. Throw some Blood Machines on. Blood Machines is available on Shudder only. And I implore you to check it out if you love crazy stuff like this, because the synth community is already a pretty niche genre when you compare it to other kinds of music. So when someone puts their all into something this freaking awesome, I gotta bring attention to it. It just sucks that it's only on Shudder. Nobody has Shudder. Put it on Netflix or something where it can actually have an audience, where people can actually see this thing, because it deserves to be seen. Play the movie. I want you to smile.